Hi everyone, my name is Juan Quintana and I am a program manager on the Azure AD customer care team.
Hi, my name is Jordan Gross and I'm a program manager on the Azure AD engineering team. And today we're going to discuss how to troubleshoot your pending devices in Azure AD.
All right, let's dive in. First, we will be giving you an overview of pending devices. Then, we will be sharing how to identify pending devices and related issues. Next, we will dive into how to troubleshoot and resolve those pending device issues. And finally, we'll end with a conclusion. So what is a pending state? There are two ways to create a hybrid Azure AD join device, either by syncing through Azure AD Connect Sync or by using claims in your federated identity provider like ADFS. If you are configuring a hybrid Azure AD join device via Azure AD Connect Sync, part of the configuration process requires the device to be synced to Azure AD and temporarily be in a pending state. This is because the device must be added to Azure AD before it can be registered. In this slide, you can see an example of a device in a temporary pending state. Now that we know what a pending device is, let's discuss how to identify pending devices and their related issues. There are four main ways to identify a pending device or pending device issue. A common issue related to pending devices is authentication issues. If a device is having these problems, it might be due to the device entering a pending state. To check if the device is in a pending state, complete one of the three options. First, check the registered column in Azure AD portal. If there is a timestamp, the device is registered. If not, the device is in a pending state. Second, run the dsreg cmd command. View the device join state in the dsreg cmd output. Third, run the command to identify all pending devices in your tenant. The command is listed in the description below. Now that we have identified that your device is in a pending state, why is that? There are two main scenarios when a device can be in a pending state, either before or after the device was registered to Azure AD. For the first scenario, the device can sit in a pending state for up to 90 minutes. If it is lasting longer than that, the device most likely cannot complete device registration process because of a variety of reasons. However, the most likely two reasons are the device cannot connect to Azure AD device registration service or the Active Directory domain controller. For the second scenario, the device was once registered as a hybrid Azure AD join device and then returned to a pending state. This is most likely due to the device being moved to an organizational unit that is not in sync scope, and then moved back to an organizational unit that is in sync scope. Azure AD Connect Sync recognizes this first move as a deletion of the computer object in AD, and therefore deletes the device in Azure AD. Once the device returns to an organizational unit in scope, the device goes into a pending state. However, the computer does not know to initiate the join process by authenticating itself, and the device therefore stays in a pending state. Now I'll hand it over to Juan to discuss how to troubleshoot pending devices.
Thank you, Jordan. Let's discuss how you'll be able to troubleshoot and resolve reason one. First, you want to verify the device's pending status in the device's blade registration status details in Azure AD. Secondly, ensure that the network your devices are connected to is enabled to allow communication to these necessary Microsoft endpoints. You then want to proceed to unregister the device from Azure AD by running dsregcmd/leave via an elevated command prompt. Next, proceed to restart the device to reinitiate the hybrid device registration procedure. The process typically takes 1 to 2 hours without any user interaction, in which you can verify the registration status is successful via the Azure AD Devices Blade. Lastly, you want to ensure you sign into the device with your domain account that is syncing with Azure AD to get provisioned an SSO primary refresh token. As part of step 2 in the previous slide, please keep in mind the following tips to verify network connectivity. For example, the device must be able to communicate with Microsoft Device Registration Service endpoints successfully under the system context and not blocked by proxy configuration. You can find details of these endpoints via the Learn More links in the description. So let's discuss reason 2. How can you troubleshoot scenarios in which your devices fail to complete registration with Azure AD due to previous registration status or organizational unit changes in Azure AD Connect? First, you want to verify the device's pending status in the device displayed registration status details in Azure AD. Confirm the device object is in an organizational unit within sync scope. Then, run dsregcmd/leave via an elevated command prompt and reboot the device to reinitiate the hybrid Azure AD join procedure. That's it for this video. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Juan. We hope you found this video useful. Please see the description below for further resources.